Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My lovely brothers and sisters in the city of Aberdeen and the Shire and everywhere. Assalamu alaikum and Ramadan Kareem and Mubarak for you and your families. In my reminder today, I would like to focus on something very, very important. And I would like you to be focused with me in the first part of my talk. I'm going to talk about something very, very significant. And in the second part, I'm going to talk about Ramadan issues and fasting and some nice and glad tidings and good news for you. Brothers and sisters, the topic that I'm going to talk about is Al-Khabi'ah. Al-Khabi'ah, and I'm going to tell you the definition of Al-Khabi'ah. And this is something maybe very important to know from the beginning of Ramadan. And actually something Allah wants us to do. And Allah loves us to do. Al-Khabi'ah is a secret ibadah that you do between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one knows about it but only you and Allah. Al-Khabi'ah is a secret worship act between the servant, the worshipper, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one knows it, and it is pure for Allah and for His sake, and actually it has guaranteed acceptance by Allah because it is done only for Him. I'm going to share with you this hadith that narrated by Zubayr bin Al-Awwam. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and some ulama of hadith, he said it's mawquf, that means he said it. He said, من استطاع منكم أن يكون له خبء من عمل صالح فليفعل. من استطاع منكم, في رواية خبيئة من عمل صالح فليفعل. And this is hadith Hasan in the سلسلة صحيحة in the authentic series. The meaning, whoever among you can make sure or make a secret thing, hidden deed or secret deed between you and Allah, then do it and don't miss such opportunity in your life to be done. In this hadith, it's like a direct advice to us to try hard to make our deeds secret. Meaning, sometimes we can't. Sometimes you try to hide, but then your wife know, or your husband know, or your parents know, or your children know, or a close friend know by default, because they are helping you to do it, or they are going with you in doing it, and etc. But if you try to make something, at least something, in your life, consistent, even little, and regular, and secret, and only between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one knows about it at all, but only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do it. So do it. And this is the advice from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another hadith, عن سعد بن أبي وقاص رضي الله عنه. This hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and this narration from Muslim, the collections of Muslim, Rawah Muslim. Inna Allah yuhibbu al-abd al-taqiy al-ghani al-khafi. Allah loves, indeed Allah loves the servant that taqi, pious, has pious, piety and righteousness and consciousness. And al-ghani, rich in his heart, rich in his iman, rich in his commitment and devotion. Meaning al-ghani here, ghina al-nafs, meaning that the person has contentment inside. Al-khafi means the one who try hard to do things with low profile and in secret. Try to do things in secret. Try to do things without people knowing. And only for Allah. This means that basically we need to make part of our ibadah secret. Of course, some part of it we can't, because we need to pray jama'ah with our family, congregation. We need to pray, for example, after I finish, you pray dhuhr for rak'ah with your family. So that's, you will call people, make adhan or iqama, and then bring people and do it. In the mosque, we do things together as a ummah, as a community. And for example, you do some projects and some charity projects together. You do sometimes as a teamwork, so you can't hide certain things. But keep something not for anyone, not for your family to know, not for your wife to know, not for your husband to know, not for your parents to know, for Allah and only Allah and alone. This is my main message today to you, to be honest. And I'm going to quote this story from Ibn Rajab, rahmatullahi alayh. And this is in Lata'if al-Ma'arif. You know, he said something interesting about one of the Salaf, of the Salihin, and pious people at that time. He mentioned that this person used to fast for 40 years. Regular fasting, as nafila, is like optional fasting, without anyone knowing that this person fasting. Nowadays, we fast Monday and Thursday outside Ramadan, or we fast in Ramadan, or we fast 3 days, the Al-Ayyam al-Bid, 13, 14, and 15, the middle of the month, etc. We fast the day of Ashura, the day of Arafah, and all these great days. But so many people know about it. So many people. Some people, they need to make celebration for each iftar, each suhoor. They want to picture their suhoor plates and iftar and send it to Facebook and social media. They actually talk too much about what they are doing and what they have been doing and all these kind of things, publicizing and all this. But the style that the Prophet ﷺ wants us to do is profile, low profile, and secret work. So we do things in a very regular and consistent, and also between us and Allah. What is it? It can be dhikr, tasbih, to say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. It can be just to say subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanallah al-azim. It's maybe you say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Maybe you say Allahu Akbar Kabira. You know, whatever you say, dhikr between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in secret, and keep it consistent daily. That's what is actually matter. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about sadaqatul sirr. Sadaqatul sirr tutfi'u ghadab al-Rabb. It will remove all the wrath and the basically curse and pleasance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry from somebody due to certain bad deeds, the secret sadaqah will remove that and it bring the blessing of Allah, it bring the love of Allah and forgiveness of Allah and mercy of Allah. So this is interesting. And I'm going to tell you something about basically this in the Quran. It is actually mentioned in the Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إن تبدوا الصدقات فنعما هي وإن تخفوها وتؤتوها الفقراء فهو خير لكم ويكفر عنكم من سيئاتكم والله بما تعملون خبير. Ayah number 271 in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, if you actually do sadaqat, meaning charity work, if you donate, if you do donation in open, it's fine, it's accepted as long as you are sincere. Because sometimes we have to do sadaqat in open to encourage other people, to inspire other people, to actually call people to do the same, so we can actually make people copy us in good and joining us in good. So that's okay. But the Prophet Allah said in this ayah, وَإِن تُبْدُوهَا وَإِن تُخْفُوهَا وَتُؤْتُوهَا الْفُقَرَى. If you do it in hidden, in secret, and give it to the poor people, this is better for you. It's clear in the Quran. It's better for us to do it in secret. Hide it, give it to the poor and needy in secret. Sometimes you need to ask somebody, how can I donate, which account to transfer money to in the mosque, for example. For this, this is okay. Still, you are doing it in secret because you are not actually, this is like in the process. Sometimes you need to talk to the treasurer of the mosque. Sometimes you need to talk to the imam, how I can put my sadaqah, what is the best thing to do in terms of zakah, sadaqah, for clarification, for advice. That's okay. But you won't actually tell people, oh, today I have done this, or tonight I have done that. So that's where is the difference. And Allah said it's better for us to make it in secret, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah will forgive our sins if we do it in secret. And فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَيُكَفِّرُ عَنْكُمْ مِنْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ. Allah will forgive your sins. Also, Allah forgive our sins if we do it in open. But the Prophet, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it's better. And وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all knowing with all what we do. Meaning that if we do it in open sincerely, Allah knows. If we do it in secret to have guaranteed acceptance from Allah, this is also Allah knows. Allah knows everything in our heart and in our action. Brothers and sisters, al-khabi'ah or al-amal al-sirri fi al-ibadah is very important. So, اجعل لك سرا عند الله. Night prayer, tahajjud. Everyone prayed taraweeh, everyone had iftar, and prayed maghrib and isha and taraweeh and everything, and then people just slept in your house. And in the middle of the night, before everyone goes and stand and wake up for suhoor, you are waking up. You put the alarm 20 minutes early or half an hour early, and you wake up and you pray to Allah. In secret, that is a great khabi'ah, that a great amal, khalis lillah, pure, sincere for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So sadaqat al-sir, the sadaqah is one example, prayer at night another example, the dhikr is example, crying. You make dua and cry in one of the corners of your houses without people even knowing. You are sitting in the sofa, people think maybe you are looking at a book or praying with your mobile, but you actually are making dhikr and you are crying to Allah. This is what is khabi'ah means. This is what khabi'ah means. And then that will lead you to be under the throne of Allah in the day of Qiyamah, inshallah. Brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and here I would like to actually tell you that in Ramadan, there is a great aspect, apart from fasting and all the things that we do in Ramadan, reading Quran and Qiyamul Layl and all the ibadah that we do as individuals. We do as individuals or as a congregation, just for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgiveness and get reward and qira'atul Quran and all this. But there is something and another element of Ramadan, which is al-ihsan, which is to bring happiness to people. Bring happiness to people. I'm repeating it three times, and I really want to emphasize this in my reminder. Because so many people are focusing on the pure ibadah for them as individual, but they forgot this side. And that is the main essence of Islam, the core message of Islam in Ramadan. Share your iftar with others. Send iftar to people. Make your neighbor aware that it's Ramadan, by your gift and by your kindness. Share your iftar with maybe somebody poor or a student or a single person who has no family. It will be a great, meaningful gift for him or her. So things like that. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ سُرُورٍ تُدْخِلْهُ عَلَى مُسْلِمٍ. The best deed that you do, the most beloved deed that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is it? The most beloved deed that you do to us. And that's in the scale of Allah, in the eyes of Allah. That's the judgment of Allah. Is happiness that you bring it to the hearts of Muslims. Subhanallah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best people is the most beneficial one to others. And in one hadith is amazing in At-Tabarani and عند الإمام الألباني, and this hadith ibn Abi Umama, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, you know, صنائع المعروف تقي مصارع السوء وصدقة السر تطفئ غضب الرب وصلة الرحم تزيد في العمر. سبحان الله. صنائع المعروف means these good deeds that you do, the kindness to others, your parents, people around you, the weak, the needy, the poor, the masakin, the fuqara, the orphans, the widows, huh? That taqi masari' as-su', that bring good end of life, good conclusion of life for you. And this is amazing. This means that if you do something for others and help them, support people and do good deeds, that will give you good conclusion. You die in a good way. You die in a dignity way, respected way. Your life will be concluded in a nice way. That's what masari' as-su' means. صنائع المعروف تقي مصارع السوء means that the good deeds that you do, it actually prevent you from having a difficult or horrible end of life. And this is all what we need, is peaceful life and long successful life, and then a good end of life. What we call it حسن الختام. حسن الختام is the actually good conclusion in life. وصدقة السر تطفئ غضب الرب, and the secret sadaqah, it brings the pleasure of Allah and the blessing of Allah. And صلة الرحم, being nice to your family and your relatives, it will give you quality of life and longer life. Quality in terms of the enjoyment of life, to enjoy the health and wealth and other things in your life, and also it increases the life in terms of years and experience. That Allah will increase your life as well in terms of years and time. Subhanallah. I would like now to share with you a very interesting hadith, which is hadith Ibn Umar. This hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said that actually the best deed and most beloved deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to bring happiness to others and to Muslims. And he actually detailed and give some examples. For example, he said, تكشف عنه كربة, remove difficulty. Or تقضي عنه دينا, pay his debt if he has good loans or things. And تطرد عنه جوعا, and to remove his hunger. How many people hungry in the world today, they don't have the iftar of today, the first day of Ramadan? How many people, they are struggling all day in order to get actually the iftar and suhoor. So we need to think of them. That's a completely different elements of Ramadan, that we are hungry and thirsty, so we feel for them. That's social elements of Ramadan. And also, at the same hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and listen carefully about this formula that he gave. وَلِأَنْ أَمْشِيَ مَعْ أَخِي فِي حَاجَتِهِ أحب إلي من أن أعتكف في هذا المسجد شهرا ومن مشى مع أخيه في حاجته حتى يتهيأ له أو يثبتها له. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, أثبت الله قدمه يوم القيامة يوم تزل الأقدام. Translation. He said, if you actually go with somebody, helping somebody, now maybe you can't go, maybe you do it online, maybe it's just a payment, online payment to somebody, maybe advice to somebody on the phone, maybe just a statement of encouragement. You lift somebody up and you give him inspiration to be positive and to do good. Subhanallah, he said, it's better to help one person and remove his difficulty. It's better than you make i'tikaf في هذا المسجد, meaning in the Masjid Nabawi. In the Masjid Nabawi على صاحب الصلاة والسلام. In the Masjid in Medina. And I'm going to tell you, if somebody made i'tikaf in the Masjid Nabawi, how much reward will get by only praying there. I'm not going to count fasting there. I'm not going to count Qiraat al-Quran there and all this and Tasbih and Dhikr. I will leave all this. I'm not going to talk about the Rawda and you pray in the Rawda, which is peace of Jannah. I'm not going to talk about any of this. I'm going to calculate for you only if you pray there. And if you pray there, subhanAllah, each prayer you will get 1,000, equivalent of 1,000 prayers elsewhere. SubhanAllah, if you calculate 5 times a day prayers, that's 5,000 rewards, equal more than other prayers elsewhere. And if you calculate this times 30 days in the month, that is 150,000 prayers elsewhere, the reward. But if you go with somebody, only one person, to remove his difficulty or help him or relieve him from his calamity or difficulty, then you are actually better than the one who are in i'tikaf in the Masjid Nabawi for 1 month. Allahu Akbar. SubhanAllah. And if you are actually making it easy for people on the Day of Judgment, Allah make it easy for you. If you make it completed, like when you do something good for somebody, complete it until the end, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make your feet standing and strong and pass on the Day of Judgment, when the day that people, their feet slipping on the sirat, which is in the top of Jahannam, Allah will save you to go to paradise easily and peacefully. Brothers and sisters, at the end of my khutbah, I will give you some glad tidings. This Friday reminder, in fact, it's not actually a khutbah or a Friday khutbah. It's actually a Friday reminder. That's why we started even a little bit before the time for Dhuhr, because it is not connected with Friday khutbah or for Dhuhr time. It's actually a reminder. It can be in the morning, can be in the evening, anytime. But we do it this time because everyone is gathering to do Dhuhr prayer. The Prophet ﷺ said, the fasting is for me and our reward people for it. And this one hadith, this is Abu Hurairah. And this hadith meaning that it's a secret, it's khabi'ah. Your fasting actually khabi'ah. It's a secret deed. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَن تُخْفُوهَا وَتُؤْتُوهَا الْفُقَرَاءَ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. It's better for you if you do it that way, for the sadaqah. And here, in this hadith, he said, فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. Only Allah knows the level of sincerity, the level of spirituality, the piety, the taqwa, the level of iman that we have in our fasting. That's why only Allah is the one who will reward us for it. That's why it's narrated that the malaika, the angels, the writers will write only that we fasted, but they will not actually write the reward, and they will keep it until the Day of Judgment for Allah to reward us. And same hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned that in fasting we have to behave differently. So we should not say any bad word, we should behave very well, and we should control our behavior and be calm and peaceful. And that's very important. Fasting is to control our desire, fasting to control our anger. It's very important, brothers and sisters. And it's very important that if somebody hurting us or said bad things to us or behaved badly to us, we say, Inni sa'im, Inni sa'im. So you say that, please. If somebody says something bad to you or annoying you, and this is good for husband and wife, it's good for parents, it's good for children, siblings, friends, close people. Basically, when people are always together and we are in lockdown, so sometimes tension happens, sometimes people under stress and pressure. So if somebody did something, as they said in Arabic, tannish, ta'ish, tanta'ish, means don't care, let it go. Just take things easy. Tannish means just let it go. Ta'ish, tanta'ish, that will give you peace and refreshment in your heart. Because if you will reply to each word, to each action, that will give you stress and bad feeling and ill feeling and also guilt. So the Prophet ﷺ gave us this medicine. Just say, Inni sa'im, Inni sa'im. Or another narration, Inni mri'un sa'im. I am a fasting person. Inni mri'un sa'im. Inni imri'un sa'im. I am a fasting person, I am a fasting person. Another nice glad tidings, the Prophet ﷺ said, the smell of your mouth in Ramadan. Because it's good to use a teeth brush and miswak and all this, and clean the mouth with water as well. Carefully, of course. So in Ramadan, you don't want anything to go to your throat. But it's interesting to tell you that the Prophet ﷺ said that the smell of your mouth in the scale of Allah, and it comes in the Day of Judgment, better, أطيب عند الله من ريح المسك. Maybe how you feel it, it differ. Maybe how people around you feel it, differ. And this is good for families, for parents, for husband, wife, for this, to understand this is because fasting and because the condition. But it is to Allah bitter than the ريح المسك, the smell of perfume, which is misk, the one of the best kind of perfumes that we know, misk. This is in the Day of Judgment. Your mouth will come with a greater smell than the misk. Another nice hadith, a Greek abun in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, that Prophet ﷺ said that لِلصَّائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ, there are two happiness for those one who fast Ramadan. One happiness, happiness when they actually break their fast in Maghrib time, in sunset time. They are excited and they make dua and then they eat Bismillah, you know, and they do the dua of iftar. ذهب الضمى وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر إن شاء الله. That the thirst gone and the veins become life and full with energy and the reward is confirmed by the will of Allah. At that time of happiness and the other happiness when they meet Allah. وفرحة حين يلقى ربه, when they meet Allah. And the Day of Judgment, as the Prophet ﷺ said, there is a gate in paradise called Ar-Rayyan. And this gate especially designed and made only for those one who used to observe fasting in their life and in Ramadan and also elsewhere and in outside Ramadan, like optional fasting. So especially in Ramadan, those one, they will be entering from the gate that called Ar-Rayyan, the gate of Ar-Rayyan, and they will enter it, and then after that the gate will close. It's amazing. These are glad tidings. Another glad tiding is the Prophet ﷺ said, دَعْوَةُ الصَّائِمْ لَا تُرَدْ, meaning that the fasting, the dua, the supplication of the fasting person will never be rejected. If you do dua in your sujood, if you do dua between adhan and iqama, if you do the dua before the salam, in your prayer, if you do dua on Friday after Asr, between Asr and Maghrib, in the last hour, if you do dua in the iftar time, if you do dua in suhoor time, لا ترد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala either will grant it for you, and what you ask for, it will happen, and you need to insist and do it with certainty, yaqeen, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove difficulties that equivalent to that dua. Difficulties that equivalent to the benefits that you are asking for. Or Allah will reward you in the Day of Judgment, a great reward for it. Brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all our deeds. And brothers and sisters, we need to do good intention. And to highlight very quickly these points, the niyyah for Ramadan, there is general niyyah, intention. It's a general intention. You say, I in your heart that I would like to fast Ramadan, the whole Ramadan. That's covered the whole month from the beginning. If anything happened, if the person become ill or traveler or the person unable to for any reason to fast or the person passed away, then the person will get the reward of the whole month. And there is niyya khasa, khususi niyya, that is every night we make niyya, intention to fast the next day. So when we do iftar, when we do suhoor, this action, that means we are actually fasting, and it's in the heart that we are actually fasting, and this intention in the heart. And we do it and renew it every single day, because every day is a different unit. Brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all your reward and accept your taraweeh at home. You pray with your family, all individually, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for you. And if you forget, and especially first day in Ramadan, for some people they ask me, if you forget, for example, and you eat, what to do? Remember the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if somebody forget it during Ramadan and drink or eat, something, then he should stop as soon as he remember, or she, and then he should continue with the fasting, and that day will be counted, because this drink or food that you eat by forgetting, it's a gift from Allah. Gift from Allah. And the hadith said, فَإِنَّمَا أَطْعَمَهُ اللَّهُ وَسَقَاهُ, that Allah himself fed you and give you and provided this for you. Let's forgive each other. Let's purify our heart and start our month with good intention, so Allah accept all of us. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ لَكُمْ الْقَبُولَ وَالسَّدَادَ وَالرَّشَادَ. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.